First of all, I just want to thank all of y'all for taking y'all time to come out here and share with us. It means so much. Man, come on, man.
Amen.
This stuff real, man.
Yes.
They just blow you up, man. People that actually take up their time and show you the pure.
Amen.
Sorry.
Amen.
They really kill.
So here we are, walking in truth, right? We are the scriptures lived out in a flesh made by God. Like, he lives here. Like, I don't know where else to take it other than we live in a cabin right now for the next 4 days, right?
What do you expect to get out of this program? You put your hands down.
Come as you are. Why spend a goddamn program with positive vibes? What's up, my brother?
So that's it, positive vibe?
Positive vibe, good energy, because the vibe that we in is already too much negativity. And we have to survive and live through this negativity, which is a constant thing every day, 24/7.
Preach.
So at this time right now, we're thankful that y'all are here and that the people who are watching this actually give y'all the funds for this, because it is doing something. I'm a blood. I'm still active in the computer. So for me to be here as a gang member, yes, it seemed kind of weird, but don't think we're all the same, because some of us here for change. Some of us want better for others here. That's what I gotta say to you, bro.
Introduction day was like really, really good. A lot of smiling faces.
Day one was great. We had introductions.
My name is Stephen Verdon from Miami, Florida.
The 4 day wild journey is it's a journey that isn't taken just by the men in blue, by the brothers in blue, but it's even taken by the team, and it's taken by those of us expressing our faith, you know, and just stretching our faith. And it's an amazing journey.
What y'all expect to get out of this program?
I expect to get everything it is to offer.
How's this wild journey been? How was day one?
Man, day one is, it's boring.
Okay.
How's introduction. I mean, I'm just gonna keep it real, man.
How was day? I'm laughing because I know that's gonna be in there.
Don't do that, dog.
All right, well then, okay, how was day one?
No, day one was boring. But for real, man, we show up because they matter.
And my name is Reginald Whitehurst. I'm from Lakeland, Florida, Polk County, 86 Trace. You hear me?
Have you ever been in prison before?
No, that's my first time.
It's your first time in prison?
First time in prison.
Okay. How'd you like today?
Today was eye-opening. It was definitely a little intimidating walking in and seeing all the inmates for the first time. Just trying to connect with them, you know, and see what's going on with them and be friendly and let them know it's a safe spot for them to talk and be themselves and tell us what's up. So,
have you ever been fishing? Yeah, I've been fishing. What's the last fish you caught? Oh, that was my fiance.
So my name is Kevin, right? Q10641. Been here. I'm rocking with y'all, man. Cause I really been here. I wore blue, white stripe, everything. What church do I attend? We are the church. I really believe that, you know, we are the church. But I go to Camp Lodge in Fort Walton Beach, which leads me to my next question, where am I from? I'm from Heavenly Places, but I currently reside in Fort Walton Beach.
We had a great time. They did introductions and we got to meet each other. There's a whole lot of challenges that lie ahead. We're not, you know, on the first day, you're not able really to connect with too many guys. Maybe the guy you're sitting next to. Tomorrow is the big deal. Tomorrow they break down to table families, and everybody will have six brothers in blue at their table, where they'll be able to form relationships and start this process of ministry. It's a good group. It's a good group. They're all good groups.
So here's on mine, everybody. 4 days, all day. No separation. Because now we're getting this kicked off now. yesterday we had a chance to kind of get to know each other. So now we're even going to get closer. So yesterday we did a storm in Jonah. That was a storm of correction. Jonah's going the wrong way, okay? Storm of correction. Today we're doing Mark 4. Any of y'all go and read Mark 4? I know one of my brothers done quoted it to me. I know. That's good. It warmed my heart.
Day 2 was pretty great. We had some talks and we had some family discussions, and guys were able to challenge us a little bit on what we were presenting. Not everybody's a Christian in this thing, and that's the way we want it. So we had an opportunity to go back and forth and exchange ideas. It was pretty good.
So what I want to do is stop time right now. And this is a call and invitation. This is a chance to get right with you. You want to stop running from and running to Jesus. I want to ask you to come on up here right now and get a fresh start right here, right now, today.
Jesus, I surrender all to Him. I freely give. I will ever love and trust Him in His presence daily live. I surrender all to Jesus. I surrender all to Him. I freely give.
Today is a day of salvation.
Amen. So
they come into the Lord, and we fix to have a poster party. We're going to throw down. We're making all the special coffee. Got the Oreos coming out. And salty snacks. And whatever else we can find. Hallelujah.
You doing DOC time? Or you doing God's time?
Come on.
What doing y'all doing? Be honest. Okay.
I'm doing God time.
You doing God time?
There we go.
Okay. If you doing DOC time, you doing the wrong time right now.
Day 2 was awesome as well. We had our first altar call, and we had, gosh, I'm trying to remember, I think it was like 31 men come to the altar, which always blows me away to see that many men responding to the Lord.
We all have different testimonies, different encounters with God. Some are zapped and instantly come to the Lord through their hearts. They can't explain what happened to them, but they know it's real. And some of you have had some of those experiences. Others are being called, but they can't feel it in their hearts because they can't justify it in their minds. People such as these have what is called a learned experience. They must know in their minds before they can feel it in their heart. They want the facts. They want data on which to have base a decision. And if you're that person, this talk is for us.
Today was remarkable. So today was all about forgiveness and who was Jesus and who, what does a Christian look like? And these guys got an opportunity to hear what we had to say. But the biggest thing about today is they had a chance to get rid of some baggage they've been carrying around about people that have hurt them. And they were able to let go of it. It was a great thing to watch.
Because at any time I could have went back to who I was. As a matter of fact, as most people would in that type of situation, if I didn't have an encounter with the Holy Spirit, I would have been able to justify me going back to who I was because of stuff like that. So with that being said, by the grace of God, grace goes way past pardon. It'll take you into perfection if you understand it properly.
Man, today was really good, man. You see the power of forgiveness and watch these guys like really be actually transformed in front of you. You know, like my table, there's five life sentences at my table, and you think the mindset would be impenetrable, but God shows up, man. He does only what he could do.
Let me ask you this. Would y'all wish you had mail?
Yeah.
I like it when you do get mail.
Yep.
All that. Anybody's not like it when they got mail. If you raise your hand, if you're like, man, I never wanted no mail. So raise your hand if you wish you could get mail.
Been in prison ministry for 3 days now.
That's perfect. What do you think about prison ministry so far?
In one word, how do I feel about prison ministry? I would say it has wrecked me.
Big Willie, what's up, man?
What's going on, my brother? How you today?
I'm doing good.
Blessed, man. Blessed.
How these days been?
Man, magnificent.
Yeah.
You gotta be here to believe. You know what I'm saying? When the Holy Spirit get to moving, you can't denounce that. You can't say it ain't the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
If you say it ain't the Holy Spirit, you don't know what the Holy Spirit is. You ain't living. You ain't walking the way you say you walking.
Yeah.
Your talk ain't matching your walk. If your walk ain't matching your talk, then what you doing? You can't be serving my Father. You can't be serving my Father. Brother Carter.
What's the good news, Blue?
What's the good news? Well, we're alive. God allows us to wake up this morning, so that's the good thing. Praise his name, Yahweh, which is Almighty. This wild program has been an experience for me, especially if you know my background and the story of my life. So it's just been a real blessing. And I thank God for each and every one of you guys taking your time out and allowing us to come up to this program and allowing us to have this journey with y'all. It's been a lot of stories I've heard have been very inspiring.
How's your first wow?
It's phenomenal. I've actually learned a lot more than what I thought I was going to learn. I've got to interact with people who I probably wouldn't have before, you know, meeting God and learning the love of Jesus Christ and moving forward.
Will you ever do it again?
Yes, I'm going to keep coming to every single one from now on.
Nobody but Jesus.
forget, because I usually forget this every time, is we're going to give out certificates on the front side, okay? All right. Would the family of Matthew stand up?
Matthew.
There you go. All right, now turn around. All right, if you're praying for the family of Matthew, stand up. Who is that?
That is my lovely wife, Nikki.
The family of Mark, would you stand up? All right. All right, if you pray for the family of Mark, please stand up.
All right.
Luke, if you are a family of Luke, please stand up. All right, if you pray for Luke. All right, if you're the family of John, stand up. All right, if you were praying for the family of John, stand up.
This is my brother.
I'd like to say, first of all, I just want to thank all y'all for taking y'all time to come out here and share with us. It means so much. I'm not a sensitive type guy, but man, come on, man. This stuff real, man.
Yes.
They just blow you up, man. People that actually take up their time to show you the purity. It ain't a call. I don't need that, man. Just these guys. Hey, man, God is real. That's all I got to say, man.
That's all you got to say.
When I first came here, I just didn't understand it. You know what I'm saying? I watched everybody's love. And I appreciate all of y'all. Everybody who walked through that door from the free world, put your time in here. Especially your brothers are on the death watch. That means more to me than anything. And I want y'all to know I got more out of this experience than I've ever had in my life. I've been a searcher. And I found it.
Yeah.
I found
yeah.
it. Love you.
See Rotolo, AKA Twin, Washington CI, Journey 5. I learned a lot of things. The main thing I learned is that it really ain't about me, and I can't do it without Jesus. Yeah. Jimmy Devlin, Kevin, Mike, all y'all, man. I love y'all, man. And all the people praying for us, man. Y'all made a big difference in our lives, whether we take it and go run with it or if we mess it up. Either way, we got it right now, so I'm going to try to hold on to it. How about that?
Hi, my name is Harold Anthony. Everybody know me as Ohio. Wild number 5. I want to be honest, I wasn't going to come up here, you know what I'm saying? And when I did, I got a lot from a lot of people, I really have. And I had a nice little conversation with Jim here, and he asked me, well, why'd you keep coming back? I said, because you got a lot of good people, good hearts, you got a good team who really cares about us, who really sits and talks with us and helps us out a lot, man. And I know God talked to me through this experience, you know what I'm saying? So. Thank I want to Lord. Thank you all y'all, and I love everybody, and peace be upon all y'all. Thank you.
My name is Edward Hassel, and I'm Northwest Florida Reception Center, Wild Number 5. I'm really grateful for the crew and the prayer warriors that pray for everybody in here, for us. You know, it was really special when we got back there, for me, to see letters that are handwritten, with pictures and color, and just, it was something very special, you know. I thank you, it means a lot to people that are locked up. I've been locked up a few times, and for most of them times, I had nobody write me at all. You know, I have that now, but I know how it is. I know I have to say thank you on behalf of the people that are not going to speak. Thank you so much.
John Trail, also known as Hood on the compound, Wild Journey number 5. I want to give thanks to all y'all, especially here Ryan, and all y'all all other people that came with me and the volunteers at War Blue that had the strength to come back into the fence and go down here to this chow hall and eat this food again. You know what I'm saying? I salute y'all because for certain people that we live a certain life on the streets, and the streets was hard, the streets was rough. You know what I'm saying? Some of us, a couple had some choices, they made some choices in life to take down a road and ride with some people that, you know what I mean, we live in to be better men. You know what I'm saying? To change our lives. You know, this is a real experience for me. You know what I'm saying? And everybody else. And I really want to thank y'all for praying upon us and giving me the strength this weekend. And for y'all also, for y'all brothers that come in blue to show us that y'all can make it on the streets, man. We can be just like these people to come right back in. So, you know what I'm saying? The praise of our brothers in blue. So thank y'all.
My name is Joey. Everyone calls me Chicago, where I'm from, with Team Peter, Washington CI, Wild number 5. I came in here for the free coffee and honey buns, but I'm leaving with Jesus in my heart.
Oh, yeah.
Hearing the testimonies from these wonderful gentlemen that came in here, that's what really got to me, because I had so much grief and sorrow and hate in my heart, that hearing that there's other people like me that have the same problems and stuff going wrong in their lives that they have no control over, and it's up to God. And now that He's with me, I feel 50 pounds lighter. Got this thing off my shoulder. I love you all from the bottom of my heart. Thank you.
We're this generation.
Yeah.
Sometimes in our life, we all have pain. We all have pain. If we wise, we know this. Oh, and tomorrow, lean on me. When you're strong, and I'll be your friend, I'll help you carry on.
Alright, get it in position. Position only.
Shake it 3 times, right?
Hold it up. Like your beer. Get it.
Shake it. Alright, here we go. 1, 2, 3.
Nice.
Favor.